Hello viewers, welcome to UN College Digital Class. In today's class, I am going to discuss about spanning tree and minimum spanning tree in design and analysis of algorithm class. Also, I will discuss about Prim's algorithm to find out minimum spanning tree. Let's start. Previously, we have discussed lots of different types of algorithm in design and analysis of algorithm class. In today's class, I am going to discuss a very interesting topic, that is spanning tree. Okay. In the previous class, when I have discussed about different types of tree like binary tree, AVL tree, B tree, BST, lots of things. Those are different from spanning tree. Actually, till now we have not discussed about graph. Graph and tree are two different concepts. Tree is acyclic, whereas graph is cyclic. Okay, but if we will extract a tree-like structure from a graph, okay, which is acyclic, then that is called a spanning tree. This is just I am explaining. The definition of spanning tree is that a spanning tree is a subset of undirected graph that has all the vertices connected by minimum number of edges. Okay, actually, in case of graph, there are different types of graph. When we will discuss on graph, at that time we will learn lots of things about graph. But till now, for the time being, graph are two different types, that is directed and undirected. Okay, on this concept I am going to start discussion. In case of undirected graph, spanning tree is a concept, or spanning tree is a representation of all the vertices but not all the edges. Okay, it is a subset of a undirected graph. Okay, and the objective of the spanning tree to extract all the vertices by using the minimum number of edges. If all the vertices are connected in a graph, then there exists at least one spanning tree. In a graph, there may exist more than one spanning tree. Okay, now I am going to discuss about the properties of spanning tree. A spanning tree does not have any cycle. It means that it is acyclic, just like tree. Any vertex can be reached from any other vertex. It is undirected. It is not directed. Now I am going to give an example of spanning tree so that you will be clear. Here I have used one graph to explain you what is the meaning of spanning tree. Here you can see that there are number of vertices are there and a number of edges are there. Here I have just highlighted some edges to show you that in this way it is forming the spanning tree. Okay, you may use other edges also, no problem. Actually, spanning tree is what? Spanning tree is a subset of a graph which contains all the vertices but not all the edges. This is the definition, this is the explanation of spanning tree. And one graph may contain multiple spanning tree. Obviously, suppose here I have selected this one. If I will not select this one and I will select this one, then also it is also okay, no problem. It means that the spanning tree must contain all the vertices. But now I am going to discuss about minimum spanning tree. What is the meaning of minimum spanning tree? The spanning tree which contains the minimum weight. Okay, actually in this graph, any edge is not containing any weight. And we can implement the minimum spanning tree concept, or we can use this algorithm at that point when weight is given. For example, suppose I want to travel from this vertex to this vertex, then I can travel in number of directions, from this to this, then this to this, or from this to this, then this. In this way, I can travel in number of directions. If weight will be given, then I will calculate which is lesser one and I will choose that one. The same concept is used here in case of minimum spanning tree. Let's start discussion about minimum spanning tree. A minimum spanning tree, which is called as MST, is a subset of edges of a connected Wittes undirected graph that connect all the vertices together with the minimum possible total edge weight. Okay, what already I have discussed. Actually, in order to find out spanning tree, a minimum spanning tree, number of different algorithms are used. Here, I am going to discuss about Prim's algorithm. Okay. Prim's algorithm is a greedy algorithm. It starts, it is based on the greedy concept. It starts with one empty spanning tree. The idea is to maintain two set of vertices here. What are those? The first one contains vertices already included in MST, and the second one contains vertices which yet not included in MST. Okay. Already we have discussed about what is spanning tree, what is a minimum spanning tree. Now we are discussing about Prim's algorithm. Okay. In Prim's algorithm, what happens? Two sets are maintained. One is used to maintain all the vertices which are included in minimum spanning tree or the output, and another set or another list is used to maintain the list of all vertices which are not included till now. Okay. Now I am going to discuss about the different steps which are used in Prim's algorithm. Here, what we are doing, we start from one vertex and keep adding edges with the lowest weight until we reach our goal. Okay, this is the process. At every step, it considers all the edges and picks the minimum weightage. After picking the edge, it moves the other endpoint of S to set containing MST. Actually, it is very interesting one. Here we will start from a particular vertex and we will check the different edges which are connected with that particular vertex, let A, and we will find out the minimum weight edge, and in this way we will move to the next vertex. Then from at that point, let the next vertex is B. Then at B, again we will check all other vertices which are connected to B, which one is having the minimum weight edge, and we will move in that direction. In this way, in Prim's algorithm, at each step we will move and we will try to find out the next lesser or minimum weight edge. In this way we will proceed. The steps for finding MST using Prim's algorithm are: the first one is create MST set that keeps tracks of vertices already included in MST, okay, which already I have discussed. Assign key values to all vertices in the input graph. Initialize all key values as infinite. Assign key values like 0 for the first vertex so that it is picked first. Actually, you can use any vertex as the first vertex. It is random, but if it is given, then it is okay. You will start from that point. Okay. Then the next step is, while MST set does not include all vertices, here actually we are continuing one loop. Inside the loop, what we are doing? Pick vertex U which is not in MST set and has minimum key value, include U to MST set. Okay. We will use or we will pick that vertex which is not included in the result set. Okay. Update the key values of all adjacent vertices of U. To update, iterate through all adjacent vertices. For every adjacent vertex B, if the weight of S UV less than the previous key value of B, update key value as a weight of UV. Actually, this is the algorithm or this is the steps. Here I am going to discuss this particular process using one example so that you will be clear. Here I have used one example of a graph, and I am going to implement Prim's algorithm to find out minimum spanning tree. Okay. Suppose we will start from this point. This is the starting point. Okay. At this point, what we will do, we will check the adjacent vertices, that is 5, and next one is this one is 5 and this one is A. Now you will check the weight. This is 10 and this is 28. That's why we will move in this direction. Now we are here at 5, and then after reaching at 5, what we will do? We will check the adjacent vertices, which is 4, and last one was 1. From 5 to 4, the weight is 25. To move from 0 to 1, the weight is 28. Which is lesser, we will select that one. So we will select this one. It means that till now we are having 0, then 5, then 4. Okay. Then after reaching 4, we will check the adjacent vertices of 4, the edges. 4 to 6, weight is 24. 4 to 3, weight is 22. Okay, and we are already having 0 to 1, weight is 28. So now we are having 22, 24 and 28 is weight. Okay, and we will choose the minimum one, that is 22. So we will move 4 to 3. Now, after reaching 3, we will check the adjacent vertices, and here the adjacent vertices are 6 and 2. To move 6, we need 18, or the weight is 18, and to move to 2, the weight is 12. Till now, we are having 0 to 1, that was 28, 1 is 18, and another one is 12. So here we will select 2 and we will move from 3 to 2. Then after reaching 2, we will choose 2 to 1, that is 16, and 3 to 6, that is 18, and 0 to 1, that is 28. As 16 is minimum one, so we will choose this one and we will move to 1. Okay, after reaching 1, we will have 1 to 6, that is 14, and 3 to 6, that is 18. 14 is lesser, that's why we will select this one and we will move from 1 to 6. In this way, what we will do, what we have done here, we have just moved from 0 to 5, then from 5 to 4, then from 4 to 3, okay, then from 3 to 2, that is 12, that's why, then 2 to 1, then 1 to 6, okay. In this way, we have generated the minimum spanning tree on the basis of Prim's algorithm. Here you can see that 0 to 5, then 5 to 4, 4 to 3, 3 to 2, 2 to 1 and 1 to 6. In the previous slide, I have explained that how we are moving from one vertex to another vertex. At each step, we are checking which is minimum. We are selecting that one and we are moving. And this is the final spanning tree or minimum spanning tree. And here the total cost is 10 plus 25 plus 22 plus 12 plus 16 plus 14, that was 99. Okay, in this way we have generated the minimum spanning tree on the basis of Prim's algorithm. Now here I am going to give another example of minimum spanning tree on the basis of Prim's algorithm. Okay, suppose this is the initial graph. Okay, this is the initial graph. Here you can see that number of vertices are present. It is undirected and vertex graph. At the first step, this graph is present. And now we are moving towards the next phase, that was our step 2. Here, suppose we have selected this one vertex. Okay. And at the next step, what we have done, we will choose the minimum one. Okay, here the minimum one is two. Okay, let me use the pen so that I can explain you. Suppose I will choose this one as the starting one, and this is about the step, the next step. And at the next step, what we will do according to Prim's algorithm, we will check all the adjacent vertices and the weight, and as 2 is lesser than 4, that's why we have selected this portion. And now the MST is looking like this. Then at the next step, what we have done, at the next step, what we have done, we will select the next vertex on the basis of minimum weight. Here you can see that we have the minimum, we have selected this portion, and the minimum vertex, the adjacent vertices are here for this one, and this one, and this one. And as this one is the having the minimum weightage, so we are selecting this one, and now the tree is looking, or MST is looking like this. Then at the next step, what we have done, again we are choosing the another vertex on the basis of minimum weight. Here you can see that after selecting this portion, okay, this is the original graph. Again, we will choose the next minimum weight, and here you can see that the minimum weight is 3. Actually, here you can see that already we have taken this portion, okay. And here from this vertex to move from, let me erase this one so that I will explain it again. We have selected this one as the first vertex. Then on the basis of minimum weight 2 and 4, we have selected this one. Then at the next step, on the basis of minimum vertex 4 and 3 and 2, we have selected this one. Then here, on the basis of minimum vertex, we have selected this one. Actually, I want to explain you here that this is the step where we have selected first, then second, then third, then fourth. But here at the third point, we are having the minimum weight 3 is here, and also another minimum weight 3 is here. Okay, so which one we will select? It is on the basis of randomly we may choose this one also, no problem, or we may choose this one also, no problem. Okay, here just I want to explain you one point that it may happen that sometimes you will get the similar number or similar minimum weight. Suppose the minimum weight is 2, there it may be possible that more number of 2 are available. At that time you will select one, and here we have selected this one, so the graph is, or MST, sorry, MST is looking like this. Okay, now at the next step, which is the final graph. Final graph, let me erase it again so that I will explain you clearly. Final graph, you can see that this was our first vertex. Okay, this was our first one. Then we have selected this one. Then we have selected this one. Then we have selected this one. And then we have selected this one. Okay, in this way, and later we have selected this one. Actually, Prim's algorithm is very interesting and also simple. It is because at randomly you will choose one vertex. If it is given a particular vertex, then it's okay. Otherwise, you will choose one vertex, and from that point you will take all the adjacent vertices and you will find out the edge which is having minimum weight. On that basis you will select, or you will extract, pick that particular vertex. Then you continue the same process till you will add all the vertices to the MST. This is about Prim's algorithm. I hope you have got clear concept about Prim's algorithm. In this class, we have discussed about spanning tree, minimum spanning trees, and Prim's algorithm with example. If you have any doubt, then please write to me in the comment box so that I can clear your doubt. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great time.